Persuasion is an art. Great speakers throughout time have been able to change their listeners' minds and even move their audiences into action through the art of persuasion. Consider these persuasive speakers and how they changed the world through what they said. For example, JFK, in his speech where he said, "Ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country." Or Ronald Reagan 20 years ago when he said, "Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall." Or Obama, who inspired a nation to believe in hope instead of fear. Nelson Mandela, Gandhi, and even Oprah, who persuades people every day to know better and to do better. Or how about these leaders? Hitler, Stalin, Jim Jones, who brainwashed his congregation, leading 900 of them unknowingly to their deaths through a mass suicide order. Now, obviously, not all of these speakers are viewed as positive voices of change. These last examples even changed the world for the worst, but let's face it, they did it through the art of persuasion. Now, considering the fact that persuasion can be used for many purposes, it is important that individuals exercise ethical, persuasive methods when seeking to persuade an audience. Let's face it, you can get an audience to believe anything you want them to if you have the right facts, a persuasive approach, and sometimes a willing audience. Some people accuse Obama of this. Others accuse Rush Limbaugh of the same thing. But the fact remains that both of these men have been persuasive to certain people groups by using information and motivational appeals. However, presenting facts on only one side of an issue without being transparent about the other side of the issue is sometimes unfair and unethical when seeking to persuade an audience. Think about it, I'm sure you've been on the receiving end of gossip. Perhaps someone twisted a truth about you into something that wasn't true because they didn't share the whole truth or the full story. When people use information to make it say what they want it to say without sharing the other side, this can sometimes be considered unethical persuasion. It is important to use information and motivational appeals ethically. So let's talk about some specific motivational appeals summarized by the Greek philosopher Aristotle thousands of years ago. He believed that to be truly effective speaker or writer, you had to appeal to three things when giving information to an audience or reader. The first is ethos, or credibility. Ethos refers to the way in which a person convinces someone else to believe him or her simply by his or her character, credibility, and trustworthiness. We tend to believe and follow people we can respect. One can often increase ethos by being knowledgeable about your topic so that you have the authority and right to speak on the subject matter you are presenting. Another way to increase ethos is to appear thoughtful, fair, and respectful of alternative points of view. Your accuracy and thoughtfulness in crediting your sources, professionalism in caring about your speech and its structure, your proper use of grammar, and your overall personal neatness are all part of the appeal to ethos. The second motivational appeal described by Aristotle is pathos. Pathos refers to persuading by appealing to an audience's emotions, values, and beliefs. Word choice affects the audience's emotional response, and emotional appeals can effectively be used to enhance persuasion. This means that your speech should not only be someone else's words or research, you must tie together your research by crafting your speech with your own words in a way that is persuasive and interesting for your audience. The third emotional appeal is logos. As you may assume from the term, logos is an appeal to reason or logic. This will be the most important technique you will use in your persuasive speech, and was Aristotle's favorite. It includes the internal consistency and clarity of your speech. It requires that you make a claim and use quality reasons and evidence to support your claim. Just like a lawyer crafts his or her argument with a logical flow that appeals to the minds of the jury, so too must you put together a speech that has a logical flow of persuasion. Giving reason is the heart of persuasion and cannot be emphasized enough. You simply cannot and should not seek to persuade without strong information and a strong logical flow of that information. Using ethos or credibility, pathos or emotional appeals, and logos or logic is important for any persuasive speaker. If you're seeking to truly persuade an audience, it's important to have all three. Like one leg missing from a three-legged stool would cause the stool to collapse, so will your argument or persuasion collapse if you are missing one of these important motivational appeals. Remember, persuasion is not just standing in front of an audience and rattling off facts in hopes that your information will get an audience to change. The speaker must play an active role in persuasion. You are part of your persuasive message, and your credibility, emotional appeals, and logic are important when preparing your speech. So good luck as you prepare to persuade. Changing minds, hearts, and actions isn't easy, but with the right attitude and preparation, you can succeed. Prepare for your own success and have fun while doing it.